She won't do it. What? Look, I'm not doing that, Bernie. Yeah, well, you do what you like with Suze. Can't we just get someone else? No. I've talked to her until I'm blue in the face. Look, it's a dead loss. I'll drive myself, all right? We'll think of something. I'll see you in a minute. Well, I hope you're bloody satisfied. You've ruined the whole thing.
Call it off, then.
No way. It's set for tonight and we're doing it. God, I already feel like a fool being pushed around by my wife.
I'm not pushing you around. You're still doing it, aren't you? I can't seem to stop you.
Oh, shut up. I've got to think. I'm going to have to do things different now that you're not with us.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, you're a sour little bitch, aren't you? Hoity-toity little angel. Well, we don't need you. We'll get by without you. Little Miss Purity.
Oh, Doug, look, please don't do it for my sake.
And for your bloody sake, I'm doing it. We'll have to find another diversion now. Have to slug that clown on the gate. You know I'll have a gun.
And what'll happen after you've done it?
We piss off. Dry like hell.
What about me?
Well, I don't know. We just wait till things settle down. I suppose I'll come and get you. How the hell am I supposed to know? Look, if you want to know the truth, you're the least of my worries at the moment.
What would I have to do?
I told you, it's simple. You drive up to the gate, you stall the car, you get out, you open the bonnet, and you take the distributor. Now, hang on. Are you doing this now?
Yes.
Lenny, it's my last job, I promise. Things will be fine. With you coming along, we can't miss.
Will that be him?
Yeah, that'll be him. Now, look, I'll tell you everything on the way, all right?
Doug?
Yeah?
Oh, doesn't matter. Let's go.
See yourself. What a pig.
Oh, look, you're no great prize yourself, you know. Oh, come on, Franky, we've got to do something. How long are we going to stay in this hole?
As long as I like. The jail's made you soft.
Yeah, well, at least if we were back there, I wouldn't feel as though my back was broken and we could have a wash and a nice breakfast.
That slop.
Oh, it's better than nothing.
You sound like you want to go back there.
I've been thinking about it.
Oh, I see. Planning on running out on me, are you?
Well, do you call this being free?
What do you call it?
Misery, that's what. Being dirty and rats and things crawling over you at night and being hungry.
You ate yesterday.
Well, that was yesterday. What about today?
You're real weak, Doreen. But turn yourself in for a cup of tea. I don't know why I bother with you.
Because I'm your friend. And I was your friend when no one else was. You ought to be looking after me.
I will. Give us a bloody chance.
Yeah, well, I want a proper meal today, or I'll go straight up to the first cop I see.
You're threatening me, Doreen, and I don't like that. How would you like to see that nose of yours sticking out through the back of your head?
Oh, you wouldn't do that.
Wouldn't I? All right, I'll get something into that fat gut of yours. But you're going to have to smarten yourself up a bit. I'll have to do some snowdropping if I'm going to take you to a restaurant.
A restaurant?
Onto the RACV?
I can't think what's happened to them.
Maybe there's a rush on. Be here soon, I expect. Mm. Sorry, I can't help you. Never could understand cars.
You said.
Eh?
I know.
Oh. Anything wrong?
No, why?
Oh, you look a little bit... What? Help!
You don't look so hot, Mum.
What?
See the doc, that's what he's there for.
Oh, come on, Marilyn, stop mooning around.
Here's a flash from our newsroom. Two men and a girl attempted an armed robbery this morning at the Mauna Engineering Works. Security guards exchanged shots with the bandits, killing one man and wounding the other. The wounded man escaped in a car driven by the woman. Police have lost sight of the getaway car, but our reporter says they're closing fast. More news as it comes to hand. And now...
Why do they do it? Hmm? Can anyone tell me that?
We don't know, but I'm sure you're going to give us the benefit of your years of experience.
Well, the answer's simple, Smith. It's because you and your kind are stupid. The woman driving that car, well, she'll end up in here with the rest of her kind.
That seems to please you, Miss Bennett.
You bet it does.
God, I hate that bitch.
She wants you to hate her. That's how she gets her kicks.
Yes, I wonder what she'd do without us.
Yes, madam, I know. But I can't be watching my young blokes every minute. Oh, now, be reasonable. Well, look, we can have that rectified very smartly. What? Well, if that's the way you feel about it...
You rude bitch.
What are you doing?
Wiping my hands.
Well, why aren't you out of that prison?
Oh, I was just going. Who was that on the phone?
The delicatessen job Ollie's been doing. Is he in yet?
Oh, no.
Well, he's done his chip for a start. What language coming from a woman? It's disgusting.
Are you giving Wally the sack?
I certainly am. He lost a job on me, didn't he? How are you getting on out of that prison?
Oh, fine, fine. No problems.
Well, there better not be. If we lose that job, this firm will go right down out of sight.
Are we in trouble, boss?
I'm in trouble. You just work here. I'm the one taking all the risks, you know.
Yeah, sure. Must be tough.
It is.
Yeah, see, I've been given a bit of thought to starting out on my own and...
You? You're a born employee, son. You'll never be anything else.
You reckon?
It's a certainty. Now get going.
Yeah, right.
Well, go on. Tell me the worst.
You've got what we call mitral stenosis.
Oh.
Now, at the top of your heart, there's a valve, just like on a pump. Well, in your case, the valve has got hardened and isn't doing its job properly. So as soon as you ask it to work harder, then you're in trouble.
Oh, the human body's a wonderful thing, isn't it?
Yes, if it's looked after.
You must know an awful lot about the human body, Doc.
It's my job, Lizzie.
Oh, don't be modest. I've been keeping my eye on you. Always so patient with them dumb cows of women, swallowing their pills, lead swingers.
Lizzie.
Oh, you do a fine job. And you get a bit of respect, too. More than I got in the sort of job I used to do. You should have heard some of the things those shearers said to me.
Yes, I can imagine.
Oh, no, you can't. Not a nice young boy like you. Hey, Doc, can I go back to my cell today?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, well, what am I going to do, just lying about in here and cut off from human fellowship? Oh, go on, Doc.
If you promise to spend all day in your cell...
I promise.
Any fooling about, you'll be straight back here.
Oh, you can depend on me. We've got to look after that mitriol, whatchamacallit, haven't we?
As far as I can see, or what is popularly known as run down.
Oh, I see. I suppose I'm wasting your time.
No, of course not. You haven't been to see a doctor here for ages.
No.
You're just not very happy, are you, Mum? I don't know what to say to you. You're an intelligent woman. You can't be fobbed off with a few trite words. Would you like to tell me about it?
Well, I've kept up quite a good front for a long time, don't you think? But I'm finding it harder. I can't seem to be bothered. It was my choice to come back here. I didn't seem to have anywhere else. And these last days, being implicated in that wretched escape, have made me realize what I am in the world. A prisoner. Nothing more. I'm getting older. And useless.
Did you have any sort of occupation when you came in here? The first time, I mean.
I was just a woman who looked after her family or a sick neighbour. When I'm not needed, I...
Sorry. Dr. Miller. Lynn.
I couldn't think who else to call. Oh, please, please, can you help me?
What's wrong?
I got hurt. I think the baby's coming. There's been an accident. Oh, please, can you help me?
Right. Where are you?
I'm a paddock. And a really, there's a long road and a factory. But it's not. Wait. It's a phone box.
Yes, I think I knew it. Now, I'm coming right away, Lynn, and I'll send an ambulance. Now, keep calm, Lynn. Lynn. Lynette?
Lynette Warner.
Yeah, she's been in some kind of accident. Blast. I'm going to have to call an ambulance from another phone. Look, it sounds serious. I'm going to have to leave you, I'm afraid.
Yes, of course. Go at once.
Yeah.
Might you be, sir?
You haven't been for a while.
No, I'm sorry.
No touching.
Oh, Miss Bennett, surely.
Regulations.
Does she have to be here?
Yes, she does. Try to ignore her. How have you been getting on, dear?
All right. Just the usual, school and that sort of thing.
Things have been much the same here. Except I suppose you heard two of the girls escaped.
Personal matters only to be discussed.
Why are you so mean?
It's not me, miss. Just regulations.
I don't believe you. Who cares anyway?
I can see she's one of yours. Thinks she's above the rules.
How's your mum and dad and little Andrew?
Are they all right? Dad's been on a business trip for a while. Grandma, are you all right?
Of course, dear, I'm fine.
You're just looking a bit tired or something.
Am I? Well, I'm all the better for your visit. How did you happen to come today?
Well, I haven't been for a while and I just thought I'd come and see you.
Is anything wrong, Judy? You sure there's nothing you want to tell me?
Well, no, there's nothing. I just thought I'd come and see you.
And I like to see you. Does your mother know you're here today?
No, she doesn't. I don't care. Well, I better be going, Gran. I'll miss the bus, and it's a long way out here.
That was a short visit.
Bye.
Judy!
So that's your granddaughter, eh? I wonder how long it'll be before she's back as an inmate. Go on. Have a go. Just see what happens.
So you're back?
Yeah. Just had to pick up a few things.
Well, don't bother. You got the keys of the van on you?
Yeah.
Well, hand them over. You won't be needing them anymore.
Give me the sack,
too. Oh, don't come in as it was me, Cook. What's been going on out there?
Nothing.
Oh, really? We lose the contract, and all that Davidson woman will say is the work is unsatisfactory. You'll be fooling around with those women. I knew I shouldn't have sent you out there, you dirty little creep. And with that lot, aren't you frightened of picking up some disease?
Oh, spare the sermon. What about me notice?
We've got no contract. I'll let you have 2 weeks' pay and think yourself lucky. And you talking about going out on your own. What a joke.
Oh, get lost.
Pick up your money from the girl on the way out. Now, get here. Oh, wait a minute. Are there any things out there?
Yeah. 300 metres of cable, a lot of conduit, a few fittings and an amp meter.
Well, you better get out and bring the lot back.
No.
That's an order, sonny Jim.
Oh, well, stiff. And listen, when you're out there, you better watch those women, because they can turn nasty. Mighty nasty.
Mabel?
Huh? Oh, yeah.
You work around here?
That's right.
Oh, I'll have soup, vegetable, mixed grill, two sausages with that and a couple of eggs, and a few rounds of toast, and a banana split ice cream sundae with double ice cream, and a pot of tea, and a chocolate milkshake with malt too.
Miss your breakfast.
Yeah, how'd you guess?
Can remember all that?
I'll do my best. What do you have?
Steak and a couple eggs, a pot of tea and a pack of smokes, any kind.
Who's paying?
Me, just got paid.
See, it's easy. Yeah, but we've got to get out yet. No sweat.
That's what you're looking for?
Yeah.
You Wilkins?
He must be. Looks like a kind of fat weasel, don't he?
Yeah.
Look, you better give me my things or there'll be trouble.
Oh, threats. We just want to ask you a few questions, see?
Forget it.
Okay.
All right, fair enough. Whatever you want to know.
Grab him.
What is this?
He's scared and us just helpless women.
What's happening about Eddie?
Eddie? Well, I had to let him go.
You sacked him?
Well, there wasn't the work. He lost me the contract here. I'm not running a charity, you know. I've got overheads and all that sort of stuff. You wouldn't understand.
Tough. And now he's out of a job. And him getting married soon to this girl here. As soon as she gets out.
Well, you never told me.
I wouldn't tell you the time of day, sweetie.
So they'll be taking him back, right?
Well, I'll consider it.
Now, what were you saying?
All right, whatever you say.
You better keep your word, mate.
Excuse me.
Everything all right?
What sort of a place is this? These women assaulted me.
Assaulted you? You have to be lucky.
This one, what's she in for?
That's none of your business.
Oh, no? Well, I can guess. Cook's probably getting all he deserved.
Well, he's an old perv. Frustrated. Know what I mean?
That Wilkins creep will never give Eddie his job back.
Yeah, we do what we can, love.
Checked out the back yet?
Yep. There's a dummy and a gate leading into the back lane.
Must have hollow legs.
Yeah, well, she's eating for two, you see.
Expect. You'd want to bring a kid into this world. Here's your bill, $12.50.
Very reasonable. You ready?
Yeah, only I won't be putting it on. I'm sick.
Serves you right. Off you go.
See that coming?
Morning sickness.
It's lunched.
She's late. Better see how she's getting on.
Hey, Tommy, a couple of smart Sheilas. Give us a hand, will you? You smart ladies, only $12.50.
Come and get it, bighead. Forget it, Doreen.
You gutless wonder.
Don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. Dr. Miller, you came. Please don't let them hurt me.
No one's going to hurt you, Lynn. You're in a hospital.
In the prison?
No, an ordinary hospital.
Where's Doug? Is he here?
Yes, he's here.
He's my husband.
Yes, I know. Lynn, the baby, you've lost it.
I didn't want it anyway. That man gave it to me. Why do people have to keep hurting me?
I don't know, Lynn.
Oh, I told Doug he wouldn't listen to me. I said it was wrong, but he said it was the last time he promised him. I was driving.
Lynn, I'll be back later. I promise.
Dr. Gregory Miller?
Yes.
Detective Grace, CIB. We rang the prison, you check out. Just a few questions.
Look, I've been through all this. I was the only person she could think of, probably. I know nothing about any robbery, and I only know her from the prison.
Well, we're prepared to accept that at this time.
You've got the woman's husband, Doug, here. How is he?
Douglas Parker, yes. He died 10 minutes ago.
Oh, you're not wasting any time.
Well, I try not to.
Jumping in and throwing people's things around?
Have I got the wrong office or something?
No. I suppose you are Jean Vernon. Oh, look, do you mind if I do that?
Oh, I'm sorry, I should have thought. They told me that you worked here. Meg, isn't it?
Jackson, yes.
Look, I'm sorry about what happened to your husband.
Does that remark mean exactly?
Not much, I guess. It's just what people say. Well, can I help?
No, no, thanks. There's not much.
Mrs. Jackson, my boss at head office told me that you were a good person to talk to around here. I hope we haven't got off on the wrong footing. He said that you were one of the better warders.
What's better?
Come on, you know what I mean. Better because you want to be. Even after what happened to your husband.
Look, I just do my job.
Well, I think there's a bit more to it than that. You see, we often find in our studies and so forth that prisoners and warders are basically very much alike. Oh, if you would just wait until I take my foot out of my mouth again. Could you show me around here?
If you want. You might learn something.
I want to. What sort of things will Lily have in stock? We'll make a stock list.
Girls? This is Jean Vernon. Now,
what
Jean...
are you in for, love?
I've got away with it so far. How about you?
Malicious wounding, they called it. Seeing if you like the place, eh? If you got a choice, I'd piss off fast.
Oh, come on, girls, that's enough. Now, Jean is going to work here. She's a welfare officer. So if any of you have got any problems, you just arrange to go and see her.
What sort of problems? We've got lots, eh, girls?
Problems outside, and to do with the outside. Visitors, families, employment, accommodation.
I must have flown here. Our new fairy godmother.
What's your name?
Marilyn Mason.
Oh, thought so. I've seen one of your movies. Pretty odd stuff.
Yeah? What kind of bird are you to be looking at that stuff?
You'll see. Be in my office at 5. Okay.
Oh, now what have I done?
Oh. Where is everybody? What are you standing around for?
Oh, Bea, you and I have been in here a long time.
So? I don't like the way you're moping about.
Got things on my mind.
Haven't we all?
Girls? This is Jean Vernon, the new welfare officer.
How's it going, girls?
Little Mary Sunshine comes to the big bad prison.
Oh, be quiet, please, girls.
Seen it all, eh?
Most of it.
You at the top of the tree around here?
That's right.
Any problems, girls, come and see me.
Yeah, I've got a problem. I've been here 6 months and I never had a single visitor. I heard you welfare mob could do something about that.
Yes, there's a prison visitor service. We can arrange...
You mean you can get us a visitor?
Uh-huh.
Beauty, I'll have one. 6'2", dark hair, knows a lot of jokes.
Shut up, Bea, I'm bloody serious.
Yeah, so am I.
Come and see me tomorrow morning.
Thanks.
Mrs. Jackson, have you heard anything more about Lynn Warner?
Yes, I have. The news isn't good.
Lynn, please talk to me.
What do you want me to say?
Oh, I don't know anything.
Doug died. They told me. I didn't even get to see him again. And the police came, asked me lots of questions. I told them everything I could. Oh, what does it matter now? They talked at me, talked and talked. Gonna put me back in prison, aren't they?
Well, I suppose they are, yes.
Maybe that's where I belong.
I'll be honest with you, Marilyn. I've talked to a lot of women and read a lot of books, but I really can't understand how you can do your job.
Well, you just give men what they want. You know about men, don't you?
Oh, sort of. Probably not as much as you do.
Sometimes they're nice to me and it's easy money. Hey, where did you see one of my movies?
The police showed it to me. I was doing an article on the degradation of women.
What does that mean?
Well, it means this. You've been taking money, how a lot of women do, and you've been used. You play a sick little game to con lonely men into using you. Using you as their mummy or as the girlfriend that they could never find. Or just a body. A warm little doll that they can do anything they like with. And where does that leave you? Answer, it doesn't. You're invisible. Oh, sure, you're laughing at the stupid Johns and taking their money. But you're nobody.
What am I supposed to do if I worked in a factory or a shop? I'd still be nobody.
Well, we can talk about that if you want to. When I saw you today, I thought, now there's a girl thinking very hard about planning her next mistake.
Oh, look, do you want me to go?
Oh, no, it's all right.
Please go on. Finish what you were saying. How do you prepare a mistake?
When you're in trouble, doesn't it feel easier to blame somebody else? The thing is that you're the one in trouble and nobody else gives a damn. You've got to get yourself out or sink.
Can I come back some other time?
Sure.
Thank you, Miss. Mrs. Jackson.
Wow. You hit her pretty hard.
She's coming back.
Look, I wasn't very welcoming earlier.
Oh, I was my usual rush in and crush self. Sorry.
Tell me, do you have much to do with teenagers?
I have done. Look, do you want to live somewhere?
Oh, well...
Yes or no, I'm going. I've had enough for one day.
Well, yes, thanks.
Good.
fine.
I'll put the kettle on.
Oh, tell you what, you wouldn't have a drink around here, would you?
Well, actually, I do think I've got a beer in the fridge.
Oh, great. Nice place. The place I've got at the moment's hideous, sort of a broom cupboard where the falling spirits meet the rising damp. I'm going to have to move as soon as I get myself organized.
Oh, no.
What is it?
It's my son, Marty. He's gone, left home. Well, I knew he wasn't happy, but to just go off without discussing it.
Oh, why discuss it? He sounds pretty confident there. Is that for real or is he faking it?
Oh, no, no, no. He can look after himself.
Well, he's a smart kid, or so you say, and he's taken off. Look, I know this isn't going to be very much comfort, but these things happen all the time. He could be back tomorrow. They sometimes are. Or maybe in a couple of months.
Oh, don't give me your statistics. I'm going to phone the police.
I wouldn't do that. You don't want him back here being held by the scruff of the neck, do you? Assuming that the police find him.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
Calm down. Get me that beer and have one yourself and we'll talk about it. You have been expecting something like this, haven't you? Okay, so now what?
I suppose I wait until I hear from him.
Killed in the attempt was Bernard Arthur Giles, 30, a shop fitter. His accomplice, Douglas Allen Parker, 26, a labourer, died yesterday in hospital. The driver of the getaway car, Lynette Warner, 20, a domestic help, is recovering in hospital. Warner was in the news recently when her sentence for kidnapping and attempted murder was revoked.
Morning. Did you hear the news?
Yes, I heard. Have you been to bed?
Oh, I might have dozed a little during the night. Mrs. Jackson, I'm terribly worried. My granddaughter came to see me yesterday.
Yes?
There's something wrong with her. You know, you can tell. But she wouldn't or couldn't talk to me.
Well, I don't know, Mum. Perhaps you should write to her.
But that would take too long. Oh, I feel so helpless in here. But I had the feeling that I was the only one she could turn to.
Well, what about Jean Vernon, the welfare officer I was showing around yesterday?
Yes.
Well, that's her job. Well, one of them, family problems outside. Why don't you talk to her?
Do you think? Well, I mean, someone from here turning up at my daughter's house. Lorraine can be very touchy about things like that.
Will you talk to her? She can arrange anything.
Thank you. I will.
Swing me if she knew.
Well, I know all about that. I had a long talk with your grandmother this morning. You know, it's crazy that a woman like her should be in jail.
That's what she wanted.
Grandmother told me you were smart. Right now, she's regretting it like crazy because she thinks that you're in some sort of trouble.
I'm not in any sort of trouble.
I don't believe you. But anyway, we'll let her go. How do you feel about your grandmother?
She's all right. I don't really know her all that well.
Well, she wouldn't be very happy to hear that from you after all she was telling me about you this morning. Do you know that she loves you? And she thinks that you're the only person in the whole world that gives a damn about her?
Does she? Well, I like her.
Do you have something against the word love? Does it embarrass you?
Of course not.
You know that she's a very lonely lady, Judy. The way that she's kept her intelligence and her dignity and her joy of life in that prison for so long is a great achievement. She's a tough lady.
I know.
Yes, well, what she didn't know, that she had a daughter, sweet Lorraine, who was turning into a bourgeois socialite who was going to throw in the garbage when she got out.
You can't talk about my mother like that.
True or false?
She's my mother.
And then she discovered that she's got a granddaughter with a mind of her own. Then one day, the granddaughter turns up, looking very uptight. which makes Grandma very upset. And she goes away. Do you like this story?
You're just saying that to make me feel guilty.
You can feel whatever you like. I just want you to go and see her again.
Yeah, maybe. Anyway, I've got exams and I have to be at school now. I have to go. Tell her I love her.
When are you going to see her again?
I'll see.
Mrs. Healy. Good afternoon.
Greg, have you been seeing Karen?
No, I work here, actually.
Really? Well,
Karen will be pleased to see you.
Yes.
This way, Mrs. Healy.
Hello, Karen.
Hello, Mum.
You're looking well.
So are you. Did you enjoy your holiday?
Oh, now, Karen, you've got to understand. With the trial and everything, I mean, what could I do? I just couldn't stand it any longer.
Yes, I know, Mum. Where did you go?
Oh, someplace up on the Gold Coast. It was quite nice in its way. Madge Whitten looked after the shop while I was away. You remember Madge? Yes, she was very supportive through it all.
Mum, why have you come here today after all this time?
Well, you see, Karen, don't stare at me like that. I met someone while I was away. He's, about 50. Widowed, comfortably off, and very sweet.
You're thinking of getting married again?
Yes.
Oh, well, do you love him?
Well, I think we understand each other.
Does he understand about me?
No, no, he doesn't. Actually, I haven't told him. I know he would understand. He's not going to think like mother, like daughter, but...
But why drag it all up?
Well, you... Yes. Karen, you killed your husband. I cannot understand why, but you did.
It's a long story.
Look, there can't be any excuses. If there were, you could have brought them up at your trial. Well, you must have been sick. Balanced. I mean, Wayne was always a perfect gentleman. Generous, charming.
To you, to me, he was a swine.
Oh, Karen, I knew Wayne. Swine? What does that mean? Did he raise his voice to you occasionally? Hit you even? I mean, you are my daughter, and God knows I love you, but...
You're afraid of me, aren't you? You think your daughter's turned into some kind of freak. Well, there were a lot of things I didn't say at my trial. I thought I was guilty. That was enough.
Well, you have to pay for your actions.
Listen to me. Some people like Greg Miller...
How horrible having an old sweetheart...
Listen to me, Mum. I could get a retrial. Even get my sentence reduced.
Retrial? Retrial? But you've already admitted you're guilty. What are you trying to do? Are you trying to put me through all that again? All those slurs and whispers and... What could you possibly say at any retrial? You say he was a swine. Perhaps on some twisted scale of liberated values he was, but my God! You are a murderess!